Jain, the students of class 10th. Students, today we are going to start our fourth chapter, that is from the diary of Anne Frank. This story is too long, and according to your board examination, that lesson is very important to you. So your concentration level must be high. You will see all the aspects, you will see all the explanation in detail and with concentration, right? So my dear students, first of all I will tell you the introduction. So this lesson is an excerpt jo hai, excerpt from diary of a young girl, or you can say the diary of Anne Frank. It is an autobiography that was the firstly published in 1947. In this, Anne expresses her thoughts in a diary which was gifted to her on her 13th birthday. She named the diary Kitty, which she considers as her only true friend. She mentions about his childhood, her family, and a lot of other things that she told no one else. That means now here you can say the writing a diary is just a private job, and if someone is writing a diary, that means he will write something that cannot be describable to other one, right? So here now we will start our first paragraphs. Writing in a diary is a really strange experience for someone like me, not only because I have never written anything before, but also because it seems to me that later on neither I nor anyone else will be interested in the musings of a 13-year-old schoolgirl. Oh, well, it doesn't matter. I feel like writing, and I have an even greater need to get all kind of things off my chest. Musing means a period of reflection or thought. The author feels that it is strange and unusual for her to write in a diary about her feelings and experiences because it was the first time she was doing it. She feels this because she thinks that in future no one would be interested in about a young girl going past. She thinks that later even she will not be interested in reading, but then she puts these thoughts away and decides that she should write if she feels like doing so. She feels the need to write because there were a lot of thoughts she had been holding on lately and she needed to get them off her mind. It is known that writing one's thoughts act as their therapy. She makes a decision of writing a diary. Paper has more patience than people. I thought of this saying on one of those days when I was feeling a little depressed and was sitting at home with my chin in my hands, bored and listless, wondering whether to stay in or go out. I finally stayed where I was, brooding. Yes, paper does have more patience, and since I am not planning to let anyone else read this stiff-baked notebook grandly referred to as diary, unless I should ever find a real friend, it probably would not make a bit difference. Listless means with no energy or interest. Brooding means engaged in sowing deep thought about something that makes one sad, angry or worried. Promoted means provoked. The author feels that proper has much more capacity to absorb thoughts than people. People have low patience levels, but a piece of paper being a non-living thing would not refuse from absorbing her thoughts. Her realization came to her one day when she was feeling more sad and confused than usual. She could not even decide whether to go or to stay at home at the same time. When she finally decided to stay at home, she sat being depressed and deep thought. Again, she thought that the paper had more patience, and she decided to write everything that came in her mind because she did not intend on making someone read it unless she found a real friend. By real friend, she meant a friend with whom she could share all her secrets. That author comes back to the point where she thought of beginning to write. It was because she is lonely, has no friend to talk. So now I am back to the point that prompted to keep a diary in first place. I don't have friend. Let me put it more clearly. Since no one will believe that a 13-year-old girl is completely alone in this world, and I am not. I have loving parents, a 16-year-old sister, and there are 30 people I can call friends. आई हैव अ फैमिली लविंग आंट्स एंड अ गुड होम नो वन ऑन द सर्फेस आई सीम टू हैव एवरी थिंग एक्सेप्ट माई वन ट्रू फ्रेंड ऑल आई थिंक अबाउट वेन आई एम फ्रेंड आई एम विथ फ्रेंड्स इज हैविंग अ गुड टाइम आई कांट ब्रिंग माई सेल्फ टू टॉक अबाउट एनी थिंग बट ऑर्डिनरी एवरी डे थिंग्स वी डोंट सीम्स टू बी एबल टू गेट एनी क्लोजर एंड दैट्स प्रॉब्लम मे बी इट्स माई फॉल्ट दैट वी डोंट कन्फाइड इन ईच अदर इन एनी केस दैट्स जस्ट हाउ थिंग्स आर एंड अनफॉर्चुनेटली दे आर नॉट लाइबल टू चेंज दिस इज वाई आई स्टार्टेड द डायरी कन्फाइड मीन्स टू टेल पर्सनल थिंग्स प्राइवेटली टू अ पर्सन दैट वन ट्रस्ट एंड लेबल मीन्स लाइकली सी देन गॉन ऑन एक्सप्लेनिंग वाई सी फील्स द नीड ऑफ फॉर अ फ्रेंड सी फील्स दैट नो वन इज गोइंग टू बिलीव दैट अ यंग गर्ल लाइक हर इज सो अलोन विच इज प्रैक्टिकली सी इज नॉट बिकॉज सी इज नॉट अ लविंग फैमिली नियर अबाउट 30 पीपल कैन बी कॉल्स फ्रेंड्स लविंग आंट्स अ गुड प्लेस टू स्टे दिस डिपिक्ट्स अ क्लियर पिक्चर ऑफ योर हैप्पी फैमिली बट द वन थिंग दैट लैक्स इन हर लाइफ इज द प्रेजेंस ऑफ अ ट्रू फ्रेंड विथ हुम सी कैन शेयर एवरीथिंग सी डज हैव अ गुड टाइम विथ फ्रेंड्स दे टॉक अबाउट स्टफ बट नॉट रियल स्टफ दैट इज एक्चुअली गोइंग ऑन इन देयर लाइव्स Despite trying hard, they are unable to get closer. She feels that maybe it is her who is not able to trust anyone with her private stuff that she is not able to come any close to her friends. She feels that the current situation cannot be changed and thus she needs to write her feelings in the diary. Now, to enhance the image of this long-awaited friend in my imagination, I don't want to jot down the facts in this diary. The way most people would do, but I want the diary to be my friend, and I am going to call this friend Kitty. Now, since no one would understand that my story of Kitty if I were plunged right in, I would be better provide a brief sketch of my life, much as I dislike doing so. Enhance means intensify. Plunge means jump or dive quickly. Usually when someone is writing in a diary, they list down all the facts about them in a formal manner, which the author does not want to do. This is because she wanted to give her need for a friend a shape and thus decides to name the diary as Kitty. Hoping that someone would read her diary one day, she thinks that writing without giving details about backgrounds, the story would be ineffective. So despite not wanting to do so, she gives brief details about her life. My father, most adorable father I have ever seen, did not marry my mother until he was 36 and she was 25. My sister Margot was born in Frankfurt in Germany in 1926 and I was born on 12 June 1929. I lived in Frankfurt until I was 4. My father emigrated to Holland in 1933. My mother, 8th Hollander Frank, went with him to Holland in September. While Margot and I were sent to Aachen to stay our grandmother, Margot went to Holland in December and I followed in February, when I was plunked down on the table as a birthday present for Margot. Adorable means lovable. Emigrated means leaves one's country in order to settle permanently in other. And plunked means to put down. She refers to her father as the most lovable father one could get. Her father married her mother when he was at the age of 36 and she was 25. She and her sister Margot was born in Frankfurt. As soon as Anne turned 4, her father moved to Holland followed by her mother in September, while both of the sisters stayed their grandmother in Aachen. Margot also sent to Holland in December, followed by Anne in February, who was brought as a birthday present for Margot. I started right away at the Montessori Nursery School. I stayed there until I was 6, at which time I started in the first form, in sixth form. My teacher was Mr. Couperus, the headmistress. At the end of the year, we were both in tears as we said a heartbreaking farewell. In this summer of 1941, Grandma fell ill and had to have an operation, so my birthday passed with little celebration. Grandma died in January 1942. No one knows how often I think of her and still love her. दिस बर्थडे सेलिब्रेशन इन 1942 वॉज इंटेंटेड टू मेक अप फॉर द अदर एंड द ग्रैंड मास कैंडल वॉज लिट अलॉन्ग विद द रेस्ट. द फोर ऑफ अस आर स्टिल डूइंग वेल एंड दैट ब्रिंग्स मी टू द प्रेजेंट डेट ऑफ 20th of June 1942, द सोलेमन डेडिकेशन ऑफ माई डायरी. नाउ हियर इन हॉलैंड एनी वॉज साइलेंट सेंट टू द मॉन्टेसरी नर्सरी स्कूल एंड इट वॉज हर फर्स्ट स्कूल. सी स्टार्टेड फ्रॉम द फर्स्ट फॉर्म. सी हैड मिसेस कुपेरस द हेड मिस्ट्रेस एज हर टीचर इन द सिक्स्थ फ्रॉम हु इवन क्राइड एट द टाइम ऑफ फेयरवेल. इन 1941 द ऑथर्स बर्थडे कुड बी सेलिब्रेटेड दैट सॉरी कुड नॉट बी सेलिब्रेटेड वेल बिकॉज हर ग्रैंड मदर फेल एंड इल अंडरवेंट एन ऑपरेशन. Now the meaning of intended means planned. Solemn means that is the deep sincerity, and dedication means commitment. Unfortunately, her grandmother left them in January 1942. Annie misses her grandmother more than anyone knows this year's because this year's birthday was to be celebrated with great zeal, so as to compensate for the last years. She then mentions that her family is doing well, which sums up her background and brings her the present date on June 20, 1942, when she is writing her diary. And what she is writing in her diary, like, dearest Kitty, our entire class is quacking in its boot. The reason, of course, is the forthcoming meeting in which the teachers decided who will move up the next form and who will be kept back. Half of the class is making bets. Gian and I laugh ourselves silly at the two boys behind us, Cian and Jax, who have stacked their entire holiday saving on their bet from morning to night. It's you are going to pass. No, I'm not. Yes, you are. No, I'm not. Even G's pleading glances at my angry outburst can't calm them down. If you ask me, there are so many dummies that about a quarter of the class should be kept back, but the teachers are the most unpredictable creature on the earth. I'm not so worried about my girlfriends and myself. We'll make it. The only subject I'm not sure about is maths. Anyway, all we can do is wait. Until then, we keep telling each other not to lose heart. So here, quacking means shake. Stacked means bet. Pleading means to make an emotional appeal. Glances means take a brief or hurried look. Outburst means a sudden release of strong emotions. Dummies means an object designed to resemble. Unpredictable means not able to be predicted. Okay. So here on June 20, 1942, Annie begins writing in her diary, addressing it as her friend Kitty. She mentions how her entire class is nervous about the result. It is unpredictable and will be decided by a meeting of teachers. Some students were talking about to move up in the next class. Some had put in their entire summer savings at stake. She and her friend G also made fun for the nervous boys. They kept on saying that you are going to pass or not. G was polite and she tried to stop them for making a noise while Anne scolded them. But none of it worked. According to Annie, about a quarter class should not be allowed to pass because they hardly respond or take part in any of the activities. She refers to them as dummies. And the author says, she is not bothered about her friends because she is sure that they will pass. The only thing they can do is the only subject that is unsure about is mathematics. She seems to have been having a tough time with the subject, but all they could do was to wait and result and not to lose their hope. I get along pretty well with all my teachers. There are 9 of them, 7 men and 2 women. Mr. Keezing and the old Fedgy who teaches maths was annoyed with me for ages because I talked so much after several warnings. He assigned me extra homework and essay on the subject, a chatterbox. What can you write about that? I would worry about that letter. I decided I jotted down the title in my notebook, tucked it in my bag and tried to keep quiet. After that, old fogey means old fashioned person. Annoyed means irritated. Chatterbox means a person who is talkative, and jotted means write quickly. Now here she tells how she has a great relationship with all her teachers except the maths professor. He was constantly irritated by the author's talkativeness, despite several warnings, and did not stop talking in classes, which prompted him to give her extra work as punishment. The first one was to write an essay on the chatterbox, which she thought was a weird topic to write on, because what could one write about that? For the moment, she wrote the topic in her notebook, kept it in her bag, and focused on staying quiet. That evening, after I had finished the rest of my homework, the note about the essay caught my eye. I began thinking about the subject while chewing the tip of my fountain pen. Anyone could ramble on the leave big spaces between the words, but the trick was to come up with convincing arguments to prove the necessity of talking. I thought and thought, and suddenly I had an idea. I wrote the 3 pages Mr. Keesing and had assigned me was satisfied. I argued that talking is a student's trait and that I would do my best to keep it under control, but that I would never be able to cure myself of the habit, since my mother talked as much as I did, if not more. And then there's not much you can do about inherited traits. So here, meaning of ramble means to talk or to write at a length in confused ways. Convincing means capable of causing someone to believe that something is true. Trait means quality. Inherited means derived genetically from one's parents or ancestors. Now the author came across the note she made as a reminder for the essay after she had finished the rest of her homework. She began thinking about the topic while chewing the tip of the fountain pen. It's a gesture that signifies a person is in deep thinking. While anyone could mention random stuff written for the sake of filling pages, she wanted to present concrete arguments in support of talking. She mentioned that she will try to better herself as a student, but talking is something that cannot be eliminated completely. This is because she got it as an inherited trait from her mother, and this is how she ended up writing 3 pages on the topic. Mr. Keesing had a good laugh at my arguments, but when I processed to talk my way through the next lesson, he assigned me secondly essay. This time it was supposed to be an incorrigible chatterbox. I handed it in, and Mr. Keesing had nothing to complain about for 2 whole lessons. However, during the 3rd lesson, he had finally enough Annie Frank as a punishment for taking in class write an essay entitled "Quack Quack Quack," said Mistress Chatterbox. Proceeded means to begin a course of action. Incorrigible means not able to be changed, and mistress means a woman in a position of authority. The professor found Anne's arguments to be amusing, but when she did not stop talking in the next lesson, he gave another punishment and to write another essay on a topic, an incorrigible chatterbox. So he gave her the topic because he was annoyed of her unstoppable chattering during the lessons. On receiving the assignment, the professor did not say anything to her for a while, but when he lost his patience, he handed her yet another assignment as the punishment on the topic "Quack, quack, quack," said Mistress Chatterbox. The class roared. I had to laugh too, though I had nearly exhausted my ingenuity on the topic of chatterboxes, it was time to come up with something else, something original. My friend Sani, who good at poetry, offered to help me write the essay from beginning to end in verse, and I jumped for joy. Mr. Keezing was trying to play a joke on me with this ridiculous subject, but I had made sure the joke was on him. Roared means laughed, exhausted means completely used up. Ingenuity means the quality of being clever. Verse means writing arranged with metrical rhythm. And ridiculous means deserving or inviting derision. When the professor scolded for the third time and punished her, the whole class started laughing. As a result, she had to pretend to be amused too. After writing twice on similar topics, she ran out of thoughts. Thus, her friend Sani, who was good at poetry, offered to help her write in rhyme. This whole assignment scenario was to make Annie feel ashamed, but she made sure that she gave an effective reply. I finished my poem and it was beautiful. It was about a mother duck and a father swan, with three babies ducklings who were beaten to death by the father because they quacked too much. Luckily, Mr. Keezing took the joke the right way. He read the poem to the class, adding his own comments, and to several classes as well. Since then, I have been allowed to talk and I have not been assigned any extra homework. On the contrary, Mr. Keezing always making jokes these days. I finished. Contrary means opposite in nature. She finally wrote her third assignment in the form of a poem, which turned out to be great. She wrote a satire that a father swan beat his three baby ducklings to death because of their noisy nature. To her good luck, the professor took it lightly. The professor recited the entire poem in front of the class while giving his own remarks simultaneously. The author, being fortunate enough, talked uninterruptedly after the incident without any further homework as a punishment. And also, Mr. Keezing, the professor, started cracking the jokes every now and then in front of the class. So, my dear students, that was all about this lesson. Okay, now again, I'm going to summarize you this lesson. So, what was the summary? In this lesson, Annie talks about being lonely and having no one to talk to, despite being surrounded by the family and about 30 people whom she called her friends. Thus, what she has done, she takes the decision of writing a letter, writing her feelings in a diary. And that's why she has put a diary as a friend whose name she has put was Kitty. She is not going to mention just facts in it. She starts with writing her background to make it easier to understand for anyone who read it later. And she has predicted there all through her life, whatever she has faced. So that was all about this lesson, my dear students. Second unit of this, that means the poem of same chapter, will be covered in next video. So up to the time, my dear students, I'm going to take a leave. We'll meet at the same session. Up to the time, thank you, have a nice day, and Jai Hind.